Hello guys, welcome to Famine Reaction. My name is Chris.
My name is Lucy.
If you're new to this channel, welcome.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Welcome. Oh, what happened to the light? Oh, crazy.
Ooh.
It's going crazy right now. Mm. Give me a second, I'll just turn this a little bit that way. Thank you.
It made me look even whiter than I really am.
Well, I should, because I'm a vampire. No, okay, before we start this video, please go check out our vlog channel, which is in the description below. It's a lot of fun, you know, if you like to get to know what we do in our daily life.
A lot of fun for you, except we have to go into forests in the middle of the night. Midnight. Even later, or earlier, depending which way you look at it.
Not just forests, but haunted locations.
Cemeteries. All sorts of places.
Abandoned buildings where the demons come and rip my heart out and eat it for their breakfast.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm kidding, okay?
They've been in mine.
Today we're gonna take a look at something that I really like because I love playing games! Yeah, okay. we're gonna play something from Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon Breakpoint. Okay, well, Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six is what I play, so let's hopefully see what this have to offer, okay? Let's jump right into it, shall we, madame?
Let's do it.
May contain improved children. This is why I love game controllers. Oh wait, that's nice. Target in sight, target lost.
I am a ghost, an elite soldier. Trained to strike my enemies before they know I exist.
Yeah. But so is he, man.
Death stalks me.
Cinematic, isn't it?
Yeah, I love it.
Never surrendering.
Whoa.
And with my brothers and sisters at my side.
Oh, I love it.
There is no fight we fear.
I know why I want a drone.
Yeah, I want a drone.
Wow, ballistic, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, drones that shoot.
We are ghosts.
Uh-oh.
We aren't afraid of death.
Boom. I expected the car to blow up though. Yeah, boy.
I'm a ghost too.
Oh, I know him.
Nothing less.
I know that guy. Yeah. I know I'm from The Walking Dead.
Ghost Breakpoint.
I want to have this game.
And you're saying these are the guys that created Rainbow Six Siege as well?
Yeah, they're Tom Clancy's. So, you know what?
Wow.
Awesome, I want this game. And when is it coming? Pre-order now for Guaranteed Beta, October 4th. Oh, it's already out.
It's out.
Ghost Recon Breakpoint. I want this game.
It looks amazing. I just can't. I mean, obviously, it is. It says official cinematic. So cinematic. It's amazing. Yeah, it looks
it's
really, really good.
As a gamer, for me, this looked like a masterpiece, and I was so blown
I'm not
away.
A gamer, that's the thing. So I'm just like, whoa, I'm always like amazed at just how realistic everything looks and how amazing. I would love to get into it. It's just so hard to find the time. But it is something that Chris is always saying, oh, I'm going to get you a gaming computer at some point and then teach you how to play. And then I'm sure I'm the sort of person that would get addicted really quickly because I'm like that when I like something. I'm really kind of, you know.
I mean,
but it looks amazing. I can see why people love this kind of stuff.
Because it is to play computer games, it's very fun. I mean, I'm not a typical Xbox guy or a PlayStation 4 guy or something like that. I only play on PC because I find it a lot easier. While my cousin, right? He only played PlayStation, right? And I'm just like, okay, I find it really hard to play PlayStation like this with these controllers and all that. I can't make it do what I want to do. Where mouse and with the computer, it's just so easy. I just like, okay,
you're
I'm
used
the master.
To it, I guess,
yeah.
You know, it's just
exactly.
Whatever you're
so
used
it's,
to.
It's so easy, yeah. And
yeah.
This is what makes me want to make games. And
it is amazing, I have to admit. Like, because I used to be a bit, I have to admit, quite anti, you know, gaming, really. I used to think of it as really time-wasting. I would appreciate it. I'm the sort of person that I'd be like looking over someone's shoulder and go, whoa, that looks amazing. But at the same time, back of my head, I'm like, no, it's time wasting. I'm not going to do it. But actually, it's amazing. I can imagine, you know, getting involved in a world like that and just, yeah, it looks very cool. I mean, that trailer won me over. That makes me think I want to have a go.
Okay, first of all, time wasting, no. Second of all, you know what? It has been scientifically proved that playing games is actually so good for your brain because there's so much you have to look for, right?
Mm-hmm.
So many things that if there's an enemy over there or there and you have to listen, your brain is actually more active than ever.
Yeah, I did read that, I have to admit, because all the things you're told that it's not good for, like, you know, because I'm a parent myself and I used to think, oh my God, I would hate my kids to waste their time on games. It's so bad for their brain. It's literally frazzling their brain cells.
But actually,
they have done some studies recently that say that kids that game a lot actually have a really quick, but they have quicker responses than other people that don't.
Not kids, but every
A lot of people, yeah,
general.
They have faster responses. There's been all these kind of games done. Do you remember the kind of you remember you had to identify colors, it'd say the word but it would show a different color, and they did this test on gamers and non-gamers, and the gamers were like so much faster than the non-gamers. So it just shows, you know, it is good. So there you go.
Same thing where I played a game in Counter-Strike, right? Where appear a color on the screen and there are all these color on the ground and you have 3 seconds to jump on the right color, right?
And
you just look at the color, blue, and then you got to see on the ground, blue. You got to jump and run over there, jump on there fast.
You'll probably
right?
be like 10 times faster than me.
I never lost. Never lost because I always knew exactly where it was. And then I start to memorize where are these colors, right? So I can be like, okay, yellow is here, orange is there, black is here, green is there, blue is there. Then I just start to figure it all out. Then I look, okay, then I knew I had to go this way.
Yeah.
So I just kept facing the screen. Then I know exactly
like
where I'm going.
But it's like everything,
though.
It's like there's certain parts of your brain. Sorry to interrupt you.
No, it's fine. I'm done.
But like there's certain parts of your brain that I'm sure are being worked when you're doing something like this. But then having said that, you don't want to spend all your time doing that. You got to read books as well and do other things if you want to be all around working your brain. Because, like, you know, you could... The only thing I'd say about a lot of gaming is it's quite antisocial, so it puts people in a dark space in a room when they should be out interacting a bit, as long as you don't do too much. Anyway, oh my God, I sound like the most preachy mum ever. I am sorry. This is crazy.
You're wrong.
Okay.
I mean, because this is actually teaching you a lot. It's teaching you language and communicating. And also to take the right choices, you know? In some games, it will lead you to take the right choices. Do you want to obey an evil leader, or do you want to go on the good side and help the people, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to...
Depends which choice
you take. Yeah, life choices. And well, there are some games that are really good choice taking, right? And depends on you.
You don't think it's promoting violence and, you know?
It doesn't matter, Lizzie. It doesn't matter. It's a game, okay? It's a game, all right? And your brain is more active than ever when you're playing a game.
Mm-hmm.
It is, because you are hearing, first of all, with your headphones on, right? And then you are seeing everything, what's happening right in front of you, and you have to take your choices as well, especially if you play Rainbow Six Siege, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is kind of like Rainbow Six Siege, but the Rainbow Six Siege is, yeah. Doesn't matter, okay? Then it's about your choices as well.
Yeah.
Do you want to wait out till the enemy comes, like a camper? Yeah. When I'm in the house, I am camper. If I'm an attacker, I just storm in, right? Which is not the correct choice. It's the stupidest choice. But I do it because I have something called Amura. Amura, it doesn't matter. She has that thing where she can shoot herself through the windows, right?
Yeah.
That's why I rush. Because I think, okay, now I can kill everybody like this. But I can't because there's always an idiot right in there and shooting me every single time. So I can never get the chance. So that is not the right choice.
Mm-hmm.
If I went stealth, yes, that would be a right choice. But then I can't shoot the person because I shoot like an idiot. Then, you know, that's also a bad choice.
But then you learn for next time.
No, no, because... I have my good days. I have my good days and I have my bad days where I shoot like an idiot all day. I'm just like, how the hell can I shoot this enemy? You know, I have those days. And then
true insanity is making a mistake and making it repeatedly over and over and over again.
Trust me, you'll figure out when you play the game. And do you know how long it took me to get one kill in Rainbow Six Siege first time? Over a month. I was so bad. I was just like, it's because... The realism in it, right? It's so real, and you're just like, holy crap.
Yeah, I remember Chris telling me ages ago, like when we were having this talk and whatever, that he was saying that he literally gets so scared sometimes, because once he was playing and it looked his hands were shaking. And I was like, what? How can you actually feel like that when you're playing a game? I was just like, that is insane. And it just shows how amazing some of these games are and stuff. But I guess it's pressure, isn't it? You're competing.
It's pressure, it's not scared. It's just like when everybody's
dead
and you are the only one alive and you're just like...
Yeah.
And it's kind of affects you at some point. And games do that. Games do that. Some games that have a good realism to it do that to you. And that's kind of like, oh, you're just like anxiety.
Mm.
And kind of like that, right? Some gamers have that, some don't, some just think, you know? Okay, me, I'm just like...
He's like, and you go anywhere near him, he's like, no! And I'm like, okay, you're just gaming, this is like important, this is a life thing, really important. He's
I never do that. Okay. I never do that, that's made up, shut
he
up.
He just shuts the door, he's like, shh, shh.
No, I don't do that, that's made up, Lucy, that's mean. You're trying to put me down.
No. Oh,
no, but you know what? When you are alone in there and you still gotta kill three enemies, the pressure is on you and it's somehow anxiety, especially if you get shot and you're just like, you don't wanna let your team down and you don't wanna lose. And so that's basically it. But let me hear what you guys think. Comment down below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Turn on the notification bell so you can always tune in live to a premiere. Until next time, peace out.
Bye. We'll be right back.